homelessness and addiction have been among San Francisco's most stubborn problems. Jim Wilson, New York Times. Good morning. Want to get California today by email? Here's the sign up. San Francisco's drug problem is in your face. Walk around long enough and you may well kick a used syringe or see someone shooting up in plain view. The visibility of the scourge is one reason city leaders are starting to move seriously toward creating so-called supervised injection sites. It would be among the first American cities to do so. Supervisor London Breed has been a champion of the idea. In an interview, she recounted some of the efforts so far to address the drug problem: outreach, a needle exchange program, and cleanup crews that collect thousands of syringes a month. But that's not all working, she said. Needle exchanges have existed in the United States since the 1980s. They've been shown not only to slow the spread of deadly viruses, but also to aid in recovery by luring addicts into the public health system. Supporters say injection facilities, which include clean syringes and medical supervision, extend those benefits. Australia, Canada, and several European nations have had them for years. In California, critics have pounced on such proposals as normalizing substance abuse. A measure that would have allowed them was narrowly defeated in the state Senate last month after facing stiff resistance from law enforcement. Ted Gaines, a Republican lawmaker from Roseville, was one of the no votes. "I don't think you should enable a person to remain in misery," he said. The push to try injection sites in San Francisco has gained momentum as the nation confronts a sprawling opioid crisis. Drug overdoses are now the leading cause of accidental death in Americans under age 50. According to one estimate, San Francisco is home to more than 22,000 injection drug users. This month, the San Francisco Board of Supervisors will hold a hearing on the injection site proposal. Ms. Breed, the board president, said she had once dismissed the idea as out of bounds. But her thinking evolved in April after a trip to have a look at the supervised injection program in Vancouver. She was impressed, she said, by cleanliness of former drug enclaves and the testimonies of addicts who are now at least in dialogue with counselors. "This is hard for me," she said. "I'm still struggling with it. But what we're doing now is not solving the issue." California Online. Please note we regularly highlight articles on news sites that have limited access for non-subscribers. Mourners gathered at a memorial for Rachel Parker and Sandy Casey, victims of the Las Vegas shooting, in Manhattan Beach on Wednesday. Patrick T. Fallon Reuters. The Las Vegas massacre is very much a Californian tragedy. A majority of those killed were from California. SFGate.com, Orange County Register. All I could describe it as was a war zone. Survivors from California shared accounts of their harrowing escapes. Los Angeles Times. Senator Dianne Feinstein introduced legislation that would ban the rapid-fire device used by the gunman. Some Republicans, long resistant to gun regulations, signaled that they may be open to it. The New York Times. As a Busher EPA official, William Wareham clashed repeatedly with California over climate policy. Now he is President Trump's pick to be the agency's air pollution chief. Los Angeles Times. The Los Angeles Times, where newsroom workers have started a push to organize as a union. Coley Brown. For the New York Times, employees at the Los Angeles Times want to form a union. They drafted a letter that called for improved working conditions, higher pay, more generous benefits and protections for staff members. The New York Times. The billionaire Vinod Khosla was threatened with fines of more than $11,000 a day for blocking access to a popular beach south of Half Moon Bay. Now he's finally relenting. The Mercury News. A Stanford study said California's ballooning pension costs would force spending cuts to parks, schools and social services. Sacramento Bee. San Diego is one of the few cities in California to have established a fully regulated supply chain for recreational marijuana. San Diego Union Tribune. Google's chief executive, Sundar Pichai, spoke about object detection technology during an event to introduce the company's new hardware offerings in San Francisco on Wednesday. Stephen Lam. Reuters. Google unveiled two new Pixel phones and other devices infused with a big helping of artificial intelligence. The New York Times. A Marine at Camp Pendleton became the first woman to qualify to lead an assault amphibian vehicle platoon. Orange County Register. The media mogul David Geffen pledged $150 million to the Los Angeles County Museum of Art, the largest single cash gift from an individual in the museum's history. The New York Times: it's so exciting to see their reaction. The former 49er Jerry Rice revealed an unusual hobby in his retirement. He regularly crashes weddings in the Bay Area. The Ringer, a 2010 house with 3 bedrooms and 3.5 bathrooms, designed by the architecture firm Lehman Weiler, is on the market for $2.495 million in the Silver Lake neighborhood of Los Angeles. Izumi Tanaka: what can you get for $2.5 million in Connecticut, California and Colorado? The New York Times: and finally, the campaign to eliminate Columbus Day continues apace in California. Last month, Los Angeles declared that the second Monday of October would instead become Indigenous Peoples Day. Now add the County of Los Angeles, and the cities of Burbank, Long Beach and San Luis Obispo. Columbus Day has been shadowed for decades by criticism that it celebrates an explorer linked to the destruction of Indigenous cultures. Berkeley became the first city to repurpose the holiday to honor Native Americans in 1992. Italian American groups defend the observance as a celebration of their heritage. It remains a federal holiday. San Luis Obispo made its proclamation during a city council meeting on Tuesday. Mona Olivas Tucker, the chairwoman of a Northern Chumash tribe, was invited to address the chamber. "Our ancestors were here for 10,000 years and they thrived here," she said, "and it really wasn't that long ago that things changed for them." She thanked the council for acknowledging that. California Today goes live at 6 a.m. Pacific Time weekdays. Tell us what you want to see Catoday at netimes.com. The California Today columnist, Mike McFate, is a third-generation Californian, born outside Sacramento and raised in San Juan Capistrano. He lives in Los Osos. Follow him on Twitter. California Today is edited by Julie Bloom, who grew up in Los Angeles and graduated from UC Berkeley.